Hello everyone. Today we will discuss position vector and the relation between the position vector and the velocity vector and the acceleration vector. And in the next question, we will discuss the relative motion. Let's start with the first question. It says find the velocity and the acceleration vectors of the above function. So this is a position vector, and the position vector is the integral of velocity vector. So if I take the derivative of position vector, I will obtain the velocity vector. Let's do the derivative. Dr over dx equals, in this question it's given by t in time dependent, so dr over dt equals. Let's take the derivative of cosine 1t I hat. So if you take the derivative of the cosine function, you will obtain minus sine function. And the inside of the sine function is still equals, and I take the inside derivative because of the chain rule, and since it's 1 with respect to t, so it doesn't change the coefficient. So when I take the sine function's derivative is cosine, so it's same with this cosine function before, therefore inside is same and the coefficient still stays same. And derivative of the sine function is cosine function. And when I take the derivative of t times k, the derivative of t is equals to 1, so it is plus k hat. I forgot the vector notation, so it's I hat and j hat. In position vectors, in vectors generally, when you take the derivative or take the integral of the function, you should still keep the vectorial notation. So this is equals to vector function, so velocity function of the position one, so this particle. Let's take another derivative of dv over dt. And this is equals to acceleration vector. So also I should keep the vector notation of the derivative symbol. So still I am keeping the vector notation, at equals, when I take the minus sign derivative is minus cosine function I will obtain. So this coefficient still same and I hat. Plus when I take the derivative of cosine function, it is equals to minus sine function. So I will write this plus sign and the minus sign. Minus sine 1.0 sine 1.0 t j hat. And when I take the derivative of 1, it's 0, so there is no k in the following equation. So we will find the velocity vector and the acceleration vector of the given position vector like that. So let's go on to the second question. We will discuss in this question relative motion. So let's read the question. A truck is traveling east at 80 km per hour at an intersection 32 km ahead. Another truck is traveling north 50 km per hour. How long after this moment will the vehicles still be close to each other, and how far they are apart at that moment? Let's consider and figureize this question. To visualize this question, I will show the x and y axis. I will call n axis as north and the x axis is as east. So let's say the first truck A, call it, starts at the origin. So this is truck A and moves to the east with an 80 km per hour velocity. And another truck, let's call it B, it's 32 km ahead of this function, this truck. And it goes to the north with a 50 km per hour velocity. So when I visualize this function, as you see, the truck B goes up and the truck A goes right. So a moment, for example, truck A is here and B is here, the distance between them is minimum. And I want to find this time and this distance. So I should write the position vectors as RA and RB. Truck A's position vector equals to its original position is at origin, so it's 0. So I will write just only with the velocity. So it's traveling to the east at 80 km per hour. So I'll write this as 80 times I had and then kilometer. So it's also 80 t because it depends on t. And the rb, the velocity, the position vector of track B, less is equal to its original at start 32 I had, so because it's 32 km of the east, and plus it's traveling to the north 50 km per hour velocity, so it's 50 t times j hat. When I want to find the the time in the minimum distance occurs, I should subtract them and find the distance between them. Ra minus Rb equals, so it's 80 t minus 32 times I hat and minus 50 t j hat. So from now on, when I take the magnitude of this function, I will find the distance. It's equal to distance. So I want the minimum distance occurs. Therefore, I should take the derivative of d. Before this, I should eliminate this absolute value, so magnitude. And how I do this? It's a vector notation. Therefore, this notates this vector and this notates this vector. So I should find this vector magnitude. Therefore, I take the squares of them and then sum up them. So when I take the square root of this function, I will obtain the original distance function. So I write it as d equals square of this function. By the way, when I take square and square root, it's hard to take the derivative. I can write it as d square. I will explain why I do this later. Okay, it's 8t minus 32 square plus minus 50t square. Now I'm taking the derivative of this function. So it is equals to 2d and the d distance over dt. And when I see this, the distance function always positive value, so it doesn't affect the sign. And when I find this derivative equated to zero, I'll find the when the minimum distance occurs with respect to t. So when I'm taking the derivative, two times the inside derivative with the chain rule is 80 times 80 t minus 32 to the power of 1, as power decreases 1, plus 2 times minus 50, so it's minus, times minus 50 t to the power 1. When I solve this, when I equate this is 0 and to solve this function, I will find the t as equals 0.29 r. So when I find the t, this is the moment the vehicles will be closest to each other. And then I want the how far they apart at that moment, I should substitute this value to the t, the original function. This is d square, so I will take the square root of this function. D equals square root 80 t minus 32 square plus minus 50 t square. And as I apply the t equals 0.29, it should be equals to 17 km. So thank you for watching. Sorry for misunderstanding. I was said to explain why I take the d square and take its derivative, because the result is not affected if I take the derivative of d or d square, doesn't matter. But the problem is that if I try to take the derivative of d, I will handle this function, the square root function, and its derivative, taking derivative of is really hard. Therefore, I take the derivative of d square. Thank you.